start, we need a domain name. A domain name is your address on the web. So it can be anything like your name, lastname.com. It can be your brand name, like Amazon.com or Migros.com. Or it can be your name, last name, like JenGoodman.com. So when getting a domain name, the first thing you should know is you don't actually own a domain, ever. So let's say that you get the domain for a year, by next year it will expire and you have to renew your subscription to that domain name. And you can get it as long as five years, perhaps there may be options to get it for 10 years. The option I'm coming across is 5 years in GoDaddy, this service. So you never actually own your domain name. Even if it's your name, lastname.com, it's not yours. You rent it for a period of time. For instance, a few weeks ago, Google forgot to renew their domain name. And some guy actually bought google.com for 13 bucks. And this kind of caused the crisis in Google. And within a few hours, they bought their own domain name back from the guy. So this can happen to anyone. You can just Google forgets to renew domain. And the guy bought google.com for a minute. And Google that paid the guy something like $6,000 and 13 cents, which is Google spelled in reverse. If you look upside down, it says Google. And that was donated to charity by a guy, so for a good cause. This got a lot of publicity. So you never really own it, you rent it. It's the same for any company, Google, Apple, whatever. That's the first thing you should. The second thing you should know, if somebody is squatting on your domain name, meaning, for instance, your name, your last name.com, and if it's not really that person's name, so let's say I squat on the name of a famous actress, okay, I buy and I want to sell their own name and last name to them, that's a crime, and you may win that one in the court. Any kind of generic name is first come, first serve. But if you are purchasing somebody's name and last name and you are not named that person, there is bad intention there. And that person may sue you and may win the ownership of their domain name. Okay. For the .tr extension, which is the official extension for Turkey, you need not to be a company for your name and last name. You can just send them your birth certificate, your ID, Nüfuskarte, which has your country number in it, your identification number. And just with that, you can purchase your own name and last name.com.tr. You don't need to be a company if it's just your name. That's the second thing. So the third thing is that the company that you buy from should be reliable. So in my own personal experience, there are a few companies. GoDaddy is the biggest one. So if you go to their about page, hakkınızda, they have over 60 million domain names, and they are the world's largest registrar as per their numbers, and they have 13 million clients. That means that this is a big operation, and they are likely not going anywhere, they're not going bankrupt, and their systems are working all the time. Because if your domain name goes down, okay, let's say you have a company and the domain name is not working, there's something wrong with that company's computers, everything is going to stop working. There, your email, which would be something like gem.apple.com, if apple.com goes down, that will stop working. The site will stop working. If you have an e-commerce, it will stop working. So the domain name is the first layer. If that goes down, everything on top of that goes down also. So it's important to get it from a good company or a company that's at least not going anywhere. I've had recently, this weekend, a client of mine who purchased their domain name really cheap from a place from Indonesia for just a few dollars instead of the $13 at GoDaddy. And we are unable to renew the domain name because their credit card system is not working. You enter the credit card, it says success, but it doesn't add 1 year to the domain date. So it's gonna expire in a few days, and if we don't renew it, we're gonna lose it. So price is not always the factor, the operation of the company is the factor I'm considering. The other thing you may look at to see if the company is any good is the ICANN seal. Let's see. There it is. ICANN. Oh, yeah. Sorry, it's not there. Somewhere there should be a quality seal with the ICANN logo. This is a mistake on GoDaddy's part of not putting that seal. ICANN, the Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers, actually they are the corporation which govern internet standards and the quality of those standards given by a company. So if the company has the ICANN certificate or the quality seal, which is that, and GoDaddy does have that, I don't know why I can't see it, but that means that they are approved by ICANN, Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers, and that means that they have the quality certificate and, you know, just everything's gonna go according to plan. Now, that crappy company this weekend also had the ICANN seal. They had the certificate in their site saying that they're an ICANN approved registrar, the Indonesian one. However, we were unable to renew the domain. What happens in that case? You can report them to ICANN. You can go to ICANN's page and find the report section and report that company, and ICANN will revoke their quality certificate for that company, and that causes problems for the company, which is what we're going to do next. So just having that logo doesn't mean it's gonna go well for you, but it's a thing to watch out for. So GoDaddy is one company that's good, meaning it's solid, it's not going anywhere. The other one is Network Solutions. These are all US companies, by the way. That's another one. And the other one is register.com, I believe. So those three are good, reputable places to buy domains. And if
have coming, you can do so from natural.com.tr. You can go to unlimited and purchase. So the price will always vary from company to company. The reason for that is domain names are actually cheaper than $13, but the operational costs of the company and the reliability factor, the brand factor, will affect the price. So for example, in Natro, the Turkish one, you may find that the domain is cheaper to buy. So let's see. In Alanotikaide. So these domains start from $9 here, whereas in GoDaddy it's going to be like $13. Natro is a good one in Turkey. And of course, TurkTicaret.net is a good one to buy domains. And if you want to buy a com.tr name, I prefer mit.tr, which is Otus page to buy, mit.com.tr. Let's Google it. Mit.tr, okay. But it's not working, which is not good. Ortadoğu Technical University's site is down for some reason. And we'll talk about why that may happen in this lecture also. When we discuss servers and hosting. Okay, now it's up. So that was a temporary cut. This is the place to buy com.tr domain names. Every other place in Turkey buys it from them. So this is the direct source that sells tr domain names. So then you have a few options. And my choice is GoDaddy because they are the world's largest, and also because they have the best control panel, in my opinion. And you can set certain things in the domain, like where should the email go, and you know where should the files go, what should be the server, the host, etc. So you can set these in the settings without paying extra. And that gives you certain advantages. For example, let's say that this is your domain name here with your brand.com. Right? And this is in GoDaddy, let's say. Okay? And you can say for email, use Google server. Use like professional Google email. And then for the website, use another server, a hosting service. Okay. That way, if that hosting service, the server that you buy, goes down for some reason, it's, let's say, the hard disk burns on it or something, your emails still keep working because the domain name is working, GoDaddy is a $1 million company, Google is a $1 million company, so likely scenario, they'll keep working while you are trying to fix your hosting service. So you can configure things separately in GoDaddy. In some of the other domain panels I showed you, you are not able to configure things separately. You are able, you know, the way you do it is the old way, which you have your brand.com. And this goes to your hosting server, which I'll explain. And either email service is here, or let's say that this runs the website, but for the email, then you send this to Google. So what happens if the hosting server goes down? The rest of it stops working. So So you need to be able to direct things individually from the domain, and GoDaddy will let you do that. And we're going to see the details as we learn how to code in this semester. But that's why I prefer GoDaddy, that's not necessary. So, and I really dislike the owner, by the way, so despite the brand. That's when we buy the domain name. Now, when buying the domain name, what are some of the things that we may be looking for? So, if it's a meaningful word, usually it's going to be more in demand. So, let's say bodybuilding.com or organicfarming.com. These kinds of words, because they make sense, they are more valuable. And in general, they are taken already. So, all of the one words in English language currently are taken. So don't even try. You can coin two words together and see if they are taken or not, like organic farming or organic family farming. .com or something, you can try to see if those are available, or you can make up words like Twitter, Flickr, etc. So you can coin new things. And your name, last name, may or may not be taken, so try it. If it's not, I would recommend that you buy it as an investment for yourself. The shorter it is and the more meaningful it is, the more expensive. The second rule is, does it have your search term inside it? So let's say that somebody is going to Google something like organic farming. If your domain name matches that, if it's organicfarming.com, because the domain name is matched, you will be found higher in Google. Why? Because it is really unlikely that you're going to buy something called organic farming and talk about robots inside. Right? Just won't make sense. Okay, so Google trusts that a related domain name is going to be about that topic. The second criteria for Google is not just the domain name, but inside the site, if your words, if your text also matches the Google search, like you have the word organic here, and farming in the words, and let's say some vegetable words, and tomatoes, and fertilizer, etc. Google will kind of understand what that's about, and these match, and that matches, and the search term matches, is going to place you higher. So you will see a lot of domain names like havaalanitransfer.com or let's say you have a site about fashion, moda, and it's taken, people will play on those words like bumoda.com, etc. So they will try to put the they will try to use the domain name. So that also helps. For example, some guy. For example, let's try to find some domain names. Anybody who can think of what I should search for? Any ideas? Just something that we can search for and see if it's taken or not.
Horse name?
Pardon?
Name of the horse? This horse?
Oh, that's taken because I have it. And that's where we'll put our work during the course. And in fact, since the topic opened, if you want to know who has the domain, and so that you can contact and maybe negotiate the price, etc., you can go to who is search, who is the owner of the domain name kind of thing here. And you can enter then the domain which is taken. And you have to prove that you are not a robot. So then you see the information. So registrar means where was this purchase from? Who registered it? And where does this person live? So very scary actually. So I just put my neighborhood rather than my complete home address there. My phone number, which is out very publicly, again scary, and a fax, etc. And my email address. And this is why people get so much spam, is because yes, you can prove you're not a robot, but still, you know, this is all over the web. It's found like this somewhere else without the proof you're not a robot kind of structure, people will steal your email address. So you are required actually by law to have correct information here, which is the worrisome part. So that's why I have a correct mobile number and a correct fax number, etc. Or you can opt for private registration, which means you pay, I don't know, something like $10 and GoDaddy puts their information on the site and provides the service for companies who are trying to look you up. If it's a valid, like, real scenario, they will connect you to, like, let's say the government, you broke a law and, you know, they have an order about your information. GoDaddy will then give it to them, or if it's a proper person, they may give it to them, and they don't give out your information publicly. It's on a request basis. So that's the private registration. You pay for the service provided by the company. So you can see who has any kind of domain name, and you can write them an email saying, hey, would you consider selling this to me, etc. So, let's try another domain.
You already is.
Which one?
Blue Orange.
Blue Orange. Blue Orange. Okay.
Very catchy.
BlueOrange.com. Again, taken. And then it gives you some extensions that are available. So, before in the old days, it used to be just com.net.org, etc. Now there are a bunch of them. So, you don't just have to go with those. You can go with blueorange.photography or .guru.
What's the difference? I mean, that's some quality.
Yeah. Com, net. Yeah. There is a difference. So, but com is still considered more prestigious. It's short for commercial. And let's say that we own both bodybuilding.com. I don't know why I'm using that. I'm not a bodybuilder, but let's say that we own bodybuilding.com and bodybuilding.guru. The com is going to be worth thousands of dollars, whereas the guru is not going to be worth anything. Like, you may get an offer for $100 maybe. So, this is the more prestigious. In terms of Google, it's rumored that .com will
holds a higher importance rating than the other ones, but this is a rumor. And those kinds of rumors, the best source to go to is Google Webmasters. This is a blog of Google, it's the official blog, and they share what are the criteria that they look for when placing a site into Google, and unless it's specified there, it's a rumor, basically. But my experience shows that always.com has higher priority than Google. This has just been my personal experience. And the value is usually almost always more expensive. Com is short for commercial, by the way. Net is for network, or is for organization. So let's say you have a non-profit organization for saving street animals or helping the homeless. This would be a better domain in that case to purchase, so that it gives the clue to the receiver of your emails or whoever is going to the site that it's an organization of some. And for Turkey, org.tr means that this is an official organization with the proper paperwork set in place. So it shows that you are a proper dynamic recognized by the government. So you will need certain paperwork to get that form. You won't need any paperwork to get that form. Okay. Now,
so TR makes more decisions?
Yes. Most of the time, indeed. Especially if you are dealing with locals, it's very prestigious. If you are going global, it may limit you, in my opinion, because they will think, oh, this is just a Turkish company, probably they are doing business there. So it depends on your where you're doing business. But yes, adds a lot of prestige for Turkey. And of course, Latvia, for instance, .co.uk for Britain, and then a smaller country, for instance, called, I think it's called Tuvalu. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, with the .tv famous domain that was out in the early 2000s, and all of the television channels went crazy and they were trying to get their .tv domain name. Actually, this was the extension for the country Tuvalu, if you go to Wikipedia. And summary, Tuvalu had a lot of income just based on and it's like all of the world trying to get TV domain names. There was a search. So, it's up to you which one to get. And of course, when you get the domain name, your email will have your domain name inside it. So, for example, like gen.webdesign.guru or something. If you get a strange domain name, it will sound like that. In my opinion, getting some strange extension is problematic when dealing with older people who are used to .coms. You say .guru and they're not sure. What is it like? Is it a .dot and a guru? And yes, and they still try to put a .com after that when emailing you, and then of course it doesn't work and the email goes back. You have all sorts of problems. So, in my opinion, .com is still the safest. And of course, stuff like digital.photography is great, but they are taken immediately. And look, here are some premium domain names. They are not sold for $13,
This means probably that GoDaddy bought this in advance and they are selling it to anyone who wants to pay. So digital.club for clubs is worth $4,000 to $5,000. A higher one, digitalmom.com. For instance, this would be great for a mom blogger who, you know, digitalmom.com, very catchy. Helps with the search engines, and you know, it's worth a fortune. So this is a full-time business for some people. This is called domain real estating. It's just like real estate. People invest and they sell it. The problem with that is, and we talked about not buying anybody's first and last name to be safe, but the problem with real estate is, for instance, Nissan Motors versus Nissan Computer. Let me try to find Nissan.com. So instead of Nissan the car company, here we have some guy whose name is Uzi Nissan, born in Israel, and basically he purchased his own family name and for his company, Nissan Computer. And Nissan is suing them, not for the ownership of the domain, but the damages caused to the company by their customers going into their site and finding this. So, tazminat davası. And look at how many times this thing appeared in court. December 99, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2007, 2008, etc., etc. And this guy, Nissan has an army of lawyers, so this guy, I think he received donations on the internet to be able to support his logins. So be careful in spotting the domain names of companies that are opening or that are going to open up, thinking that you may make quick profit. It may, even if it's a coincidence like here, this may cause problems for you. So try to, you know, invest in generic terms like real estate or, you know, bebekendak.com or hisarüstüozalit.com, okay? Nobody's going to sue you for that, and if they do, they won't really have a chance. So that's the thing, and let's see, when purchasing domain names, do you need anything else? Not really, that's about it. Domain names. Ah, of course, don't pick domain names which have Turkish letters, or French letters, or German letters. Just stick with the Latin alphabet. So then, some words in Turkey become problematic. Like, you know, if you want to purchase ıhlamur.com, first of all, let me see how. So it's taken. They offer you .net. However, what's gonna happen? Somebody who doesn't have a Turkish keyboard is not going to be able to enter your site or ıhlamur.com. They need the Turkish keyboard, or they're going to go to keyboard settings and switch to this keyboard, and even though they have an English keyboard, then they can find it. So you can buy them, but it's never a good idea to by uncommon letters. And Goodnumber.com and eatnumber.com are completely different things. So let's say you have one but not the other, it's going to cause problems. In this case, they have both. But look, I'm seeing a different sign. Stuff like customer service, do they have 24/7 support? Can you call them? Can you chat with them? Can you email them? Etc. That kind of stuff always has a role in picking domain name company. That's the first thing we need. We need to rent your idea. In our course, we will be using our domain name Miss49A, which is empty right now. You will each have a folder like that, and then you will work in that folder and you will be able to use that web address, which we'll do by the end of this lecture. Questions about the domain. So, the second thing you need is hosting service. And this is the most problematic one I have when trying to explain this to clients who think that this is a made-up kind of service. That they are trying to do a good job, because you can't really see this with the eye unless you take that to the service. So hosting service is a server. Okay? And a server is just like these computers, but only more powerful. Hosting means owning. So if you are the host of a party, that means you are creating that party for other people. You are the host of the party. So, hosting service is owning or renting that server, which is a powerful computer that will run your website. Okay. Now, first of all, where can it be purchased? Anyway, so even GoDaddy, that domain name company, will have a hosting service, and they'll try to add this on top of their domain name. Would you like to buy hosting just for another $9.99? Right? So, any kind of company that sells the domain will also usually sell web hosting. And there is a server, kind of looks like that. It's a computer, only much more powerful. And has some additional. And you may see different prices and different offers. Now, why do you need hosting, first of all? Because in a website that you create, you will have your logo, you will have your pictures, you will have your text, you may have some PDFs, etc. Your content, we call this chip. Content. Maybe some music in there, some videos, etc. Okay. And all of this needs to be in a computer, in a server. That's the power button.
superior drawing skills. It needs to be inside this computer, and whenever somebody types in your domain name, what happens? From GoDaddy, you set it to go to your hosting service. And that hosting service will then send those files to the computer which is requesting that information. Meaning, this computer. So I type gemgoodme.com. Let's say it's purchased from GoDaddy, it goes to GoDaddy, finds out where the host is, it goes there. It sends the files through the internet to this computer. So to visit the website, you actually kind of download the files you are looking at, just not on your computer, in a temporary space somewhere, until you close the button. Okay. So hosting service does that. It hosts your files in the list, or your, let's say you have a software, holds that software, like Garanti Bank in Turkey has a hosting service, and it's a banking software, right? You go online and send money and stuff. That entire software is in the hosting machine. It's inside the server. So this is really hard to explain to the clients for that reason, because you have to imagine this.
If you don't have it.
You won't have a website. You don't have to buy hosting service. Okay? Even your laptop computer is so powerful today that it can run your website for you, and probably 1,000 people, yeah, that's too much, 100 people could visit your site at the same time, and this would not crash and be able to send those files from your home connection, from your ADSL connection, to those people. But what happens when the power goes down in your home? Or what happens if there's a problem with Turkish Telecom and your internet goes down? Or maybe you exceeded your quota that month, you watched too many movies, and it slows down and it's not able to do that. So you need a stronger setup. Or if you catch a virus, etc., goes down. So you need a stronger setup. And that setup is given to you by companies, and usually you rent a little bit of space and some infrastructure, meaning, you know, they have generators if the electricity goes down, they have a backup internet line if one goes down, etc. So that your website is more secure. But you could theoretically do that at home, use your own computer at home. You have to be careful about, let's say, your mom not unplugging your computer when doing vacuum cleaning, then let's say your whole operation goes down, but you could. So the host doesn't matter, it could be this computer or that computer, the powerful one, is called the server. It serves the information to the audience that's getting it. The computer which gets that information, the computer you are visiting from, is called the client. The client as in the customer, you. So the client and the server. Okay, so you rent some kind of a server in that hosting. And let's look at the prices. So in a year, I guess the cheapest one is the web hosting. Yeah, the cheapest one Matra has, remember domains were like $13 per year or $8 per year. This one is more expensive, 65 liras for a year. And how is this space determined? By properties, by what kind of service they give to you. So what kind of service do they give to you? They give to you some hard disk space, disk, some traffic, how many emails, and some other stuff like how many databases and blah blah. Okay. So this looks really good, right? Just like $20 a year,
which is what, $12 a month. Am I right? Something like that. You get 50 emails and a whole lot of hard disk spaces.